Hey folks, welcome back for some more Banner Saga. Alright. Hey folks, welcome back for some more Banner Saga. Alright, sorry about that. So, let's see, we left everyone all healed up and looking good. Let's continue on our depressing journey. You see smoke rising from the trees. Dredge aren't known for setting fires, says Mugger, but it gets their attention. We'd use fires like that to lead them along in the Great Wars. Yeah, but they wised up after a while. Or it could be someone trying to get our attention. The other group from Slid were sent this way. No matter how you look at it, investigating will cost time. We're good on supplies, let's try and check it out. Aw, sounds of fighting ahead compel you to crash through the foliage. Sidestepping Varl and Dredge bodies along the way, you burst onto a scene of carnage, a vast number of Varl surrounded by Dredge. Alright, let's save some people. Gunoff's kind of my only, like, leveled do-work guy. Alright, let's just see what we got with these guys. See what we can make happen. Awkward position to be in. Shield bearer guy. Wanna come over here and take some hits. So much without even doing any armor damage. Why bother on that guy. You a kill off of this. Yep. Adjacent to the target, take one strength damage. One strength plus one break. One break to heavy impact. Well, yeah, shit. Let's just do it. Looked to be about our best option at that point with him. Kills though. So I'm gonna get him leveled and make him actually usable as a taunter. Back one tile, target bleeds on strength one tile. Or put me on strength. Armor break on the other one. Mm.
dude's about to die.
That'll take care of him. Injury for you. Oh shit, that's right, I was trying to get this dude kills. I should have had him attack the other one. Suppose I could just have some people rest through it. She could use kills also. Fighting wraps up, one of the Varl puts his axe away and puffs on a pipe. Hakan, he greets you. Glad you saw our signal. He explains that they had come from Schlid and were surrounded. He spotted you in the distance and lit a fire to draw your attention, at the risk of drawing the dredge as well. Back at the caravan, their sizable detachment joins your ranks. Awesome. Totally worth it. 280 Varl. Sweet. Moger comes to you privately. I've seen some of the warriors disappearing, he says. First thought it was my imagination. Now I'm certain several have just gone missing. Mostly men, but some Varl too. Can't quite figure it. It's abandonment, you can't let it stand. Some of them have come back. Why don't we ask them? Couldn't get a straight answer out of them, he says. Others denied it outright. I can't question the humans directly, but I'll be damned if Ludin doesn't have something to do with this. Well, tensions are already pretty strained from what I remember, but fuck it. I ordered it! Oh, what an ass. Sent my men to bring back gold from the cart you left behind. If you have a problem with your warriors joining them, maybe you should keep them under control. Pummel him in his stupid face. That is a great option. Pummel him in his stupid face. And he turned on me. No! It's my fucking cart. He has no claim to the gold, but he takes no orders from us either. Like it or not, he's an equal. He'll repay us when this is over, and you'll look the better for it. We could pummel him into the ground. It's just not me, though. Leave no doubt in Ludin's mind that another stunt like this won't end peacefully. He shrugs indifferently. Your warriors demand a break. Halt the caravan with a sigh, but in all honesty, you're starting to feel the altitude and weariness yourself. Moger leans on a fallen tree, fiddling with a crust of bread. Getting colder, he says, staring into the distance. You can see Ridgehorn just start to peek around the mountains. A flock of ravens float across a clear sky toward the fort. We should follow those birds. Why should we follow the birds? Why are we following the birds? Without another word, Mugger starts running toward the birds and tumbles over the cliff. Suddenly, he's gliding through the air, flapping his arms for all they're worth. He swoops toward Ridgehorn before bursting into flames, plummeting into the tower, which crumbles like a log from a smoldering campfire. What? Huh? I am so confused as to what just happened there. Oh, okay. You think you've lost your mind, then you wake up. You don't remember setting up camp or falling asleep in front of crackling logs. What is going on? Mugger approaches you at the campfire. Hakan, did you see? Yeah, you both agree to keep it to yourselves. Oh, so we both have a shared vision. Follow the birds. Probably rest for a day to get him back up. Promote. All right. Let's further armor break, and I'm pretty sure this is the exertion. So let's further armor break and exertion. We have anyone else we can level? He's already maxed out. Ah, Vassalt. Alright, this is the guy with the taunt. So, probably just straight boost his survivability. Max out exertion and get another strength. We'll max out strength on him the next time around. Yeah, she needs another kill so we can get her leveled. Alright. Let's press. Day. Dude should be fully healed. Let's get the hell out of here. I'm sure you've seen them, Mugger says, but we're being followed. Dredge have been on our asses since we left the Godstone. Lots of them. I'm sure there's plenty in front of us too, but we're just half a day out from thick woods. We might lose them there. Yeah, let's try and lose him. Varl don't enjoy shuffling through the undergrowth, but the dredge hate it even more. Most stop at the edge of the forest, and the ones who follow are picked off without much effort. They begin to creep around the tree line, and you hope you can outpace them to the other side. That seemed to work out. Deep Inside the woods, you get the distinct sense that dredge have more or less surrounded you, and in great numbers. Their dark shapes create unsettling patterns as they slide between the trees in every direction. Call Moger around. You got any fresh ideas?
Pray to whatever gods you like. There's more of them waiting on the other side of the woods than we've seen so far. Maybe seriously outnumbered, especially if we wait. So don't wait.
Ursa appears. What if you could what if, she says, patting her arrows knowingly, you could set part of the woods on fire to draw their attention while you escape, or try to draw them into a trap? Was this your idea, you ask? Shrugs and listens. Fight your way out as usual. Create a forest fire as a disaster. Fuck it. Draw them into the woods and set them on fire. Create a line of shield bangers and unleash volleys of arrows in their direction, luring frustrated swaths of them into the trees. At your command, Ursa flings the flaming arrows into key locations. The trees erupt and the fire spreads quickly. I wonder if I'll lose some varl that'll, like, freak out because they don't like fire. Many fall immediately, but the varl start to lose their nerve. Soon the caravan is in disarray, some fighting, others fleeing from the growing inferno. You fucking pansies. Ursa's vanished, Ludin rushes past in a state of terror, break from the trees, hoping to regroup. Minus 35 Varl. Well, that wasn't... Where is Ursa? Do it? Where is she? Make her do what? Exactly. It was all her idea, dude. Stares into the flames, face blank. He's trying hard not to show what this means to him. About minutes at the most. Drags Ludin along against his will, but you hear no outburst or insults. It's almost worse. Caravan with like 5-8 little humans in it here and there. Giant varl. Are we at the city where the other convoy caravan is at? Is that what's happening here? Thank you. wherever we are, it looks trashed. Yeah, it looks like a full-scale battle happened. Only dredge bodies remain. Make sure there's no dredge waiting to spring on us. On it. Take a look and get out before anything goes wrong. That sounds like a solid plan, right? Nobody's gonna be upgradable right now. We already did that. Up the tower we go. Sure, let's take Eric with us here. Welcome to the club, Eric. Time for a battle. Welcome back to the club, I guess. This guy's gonna be the first one to move and be locked in from getting anywhere meaningful. Those fucking slingers. I remember you guys. Imagine I don't necessarily want to move over those. No matter what I do, that other guy's gonna be locked in anyway, so let's just get him as far as we can now. Should have put 4 and 2 is what I should have done. Just used a bunch on Ludin, so why don't you give him some willpower back? I think of if I should just line this guy up behind, or if I'll get him into the fight quicker. I'm not really sure. We'll just take him back behind. I guess. Not sure what those are doing, though. Oh, okay, they blow up after a time. Oh, shit. Tempest doesn't catch that guy. Alright, well, let's... let's put him right off the bat. Ludin is always just getting it handed to him. Stay here, because you're gonna block people if you actually go anywhere. Now, this thing's hurt too. 2 and 2? It's not necessarily something to scoff at. Jeez, this guy's about to fucking die already. Every fucking time with this dude. Alright, well, just fucking give me what you can. Dude's fucking worthless. contract tag. But it's not really gonna be able to do anything fucking useful. I'm just gonna go down in another turn. Unfortunately, that kill is useless since he's already all the way leveled. Do anything worthwhile even to these dudes. Here, you can take another armor off for me. Freaking worthless spear-wielding human. Somebody else that easily, so I'm not a big fan of that the leveling requirement there for the having to like make X amount of kills with that particular character as well as the using the renown from just making kills. Like, that part's fine. I don't really like that I have to get X amount of kills with a character just to be able to promote them. Like, make it participate in X battles or something. I don't think kills was a good way to go about that, if I had one thing to complain about. Finally, Ludin goes down. Oh, you don't have enough. Alright, well, why don't you come and do armor on this guy then? Thank you. somebody else to hopefully get the kill. The other people gain some kills. Somebody got a promotion out of that. You lean on a crumpled wall, watching endless waves of dredge marching below. Satisfied, Hakan? Moker asks. Vast number of dredge remind you of the Great Wars. I've seen enough. Let's get the fuck out of here. Moker stands over the bodies of the man and woman. Think the slag came up here for those two? Here. Any idea who they are? Search them. Moger leans down, patting the man's tunic. He stops, frowns, and presses his ear against the man's chest. This one's breathing. She wasn't so lucky, he says, looking over the woman. Clang of metal reaches you from the courtyard below, muffled by the thick snow. You curse. Quick, back down. Bring the live one. You skip stairs as you descend, shouting orders to the varl below. Dredge line the battlefield, weapons drawn. What do we got? Take a quick head count. There must be at least 837 of them. You have 154 fighters and 967 Varl at your side. It's like charging. Gives me a harder battle if I remember right, but like saves me from losing more people. Formations is like the middle ground. Hold them off is like easy, but lose a bunch of people. Yeah. Considering that everyone's just been injured and all that, let's take the middle ground. If you're careful, you should be able to keep your forces balanced. Give the order. Start rallying your forces. Gather your allies to you, preparing to enter the fray. Alright, let's switch these dudes out. And Ludin, sorry, but looks like you're stuck. You're coming with, injured or not. Oh, this is shit. Maybe I should have taken the charge battle. I didn't need a battle quite this easy. Alright. Yeah, just get out there.
Should be time to get things blocked off again.
Oh, I guess I have to be next to him to impale. Okay. Now I know for next time. Best use of an attack, but oh well. Adjacent unit up to 4 tiles for 1 armor damage plus 1 per unit past. Or we could just outright take off 4 armor. Almost get him a kill. That dude's gonna go down. Nice deflect, dude. First, so you get the kill. Enemies push back all the way. Let's see what we get. That's not so bad, especially since I'm still basically intact. This guy's just missing a lot of armor. Those two should be able to take care of this guy on their own. That'll do it. Awesome. rest, you don't need kills. You're just here in case shit goes wrong. I guess maybe I should have sent him over there to do an armor break. That would have made sense. That's great, we'll just get Ludin the experience. What's going on? It's a lot. Just look at this. This man is a mender. Healers? Yes. Awesome. Please. That would be awesome. Spellweavers in Ridgehorn. Is this an actual choice? Like, am I gonna be fucked away if I choose to rest, or is this just, hey, you have a second? Day we wait means more dredge or another ambush. The snow may act in our favor. Gee, way to be the voice of optimism, dude. We're all gonna die here, jackass. If anyone falls fighting here, they'll be left behind. Hey, I'm trying to ask your opinion, and you're being a dick about it. So. Everyone's fucking injured. One day or two of rest, and then we need to get the fuck out of here. Set up a watch. Who knows what the dredge will do in the meantime. Might try to starve us out or wear us down. Try to hide their numbers. What do you want to do? Focus on getting everyone rested and ready so that we can leave. Yeah, 2 days will get us through a bulk of the injury stuff. Who can level? Mogur can level. What is his skill? So if we upped his armor break, that synergizes well with his skill, so let's just keep doing that. And give him another armor. Promote Ludin the Wuss. Health and armor break maxed out. And for him, I'll probably put the rest of his points into willpower as he gets leveled. So that he can just kind of wail on people, hopefully. His survivability. Since his biggest benefit to the group is generally the rally. Alright, now we gotta get rested for 2 days. And then we can leave, hopefully. What's our approach? Oh, I see. I get it. Okay, so just each day the battle probably gets, like, each day I put it off, the battle gets worse. I got it. Beat the dredge into attacking and wear them down. Break through the front lines and don't stop. Send the shield bangers forward and fight defensively. Go all out, strike hard and drive them off. Send a diversion to draw their attention and escape. Send a diversion. To admit it, says Mogur, but this might be the safest option. Just wouldn't expect to see them again. I'll lead, he says. The distraction basically means I am sacrificing Mogur, it looks like. Find others, Mogur, but not you. Or maybe it doesn't work if you use somebody besides Mogur. I don't know. Yeah. Not you, Mogur. Find others. Not sure how many will be willing to go on the suicide mission, but I'll ask. Translator with a handful of warriors, most of whom you've never seen before. Go on ahead of the others, crossing the land bridge with battle cries. You begin your approach, but before their whole attention has been drawn, most Varl have been felled. Didn't work. Fight! So yeah, had I used Mogur, that probably works, but then he dies. Alright, well, this group seemed to work out alright. Still tearing in the dude's armor. Guy's not really a threat. It's always a plus. Holy shit, that dude. God damn, that guy is so fucking weak. This guy was full. First wave dredge out of the picture, you stop and take stock of the battlefield. Your warriors are doing as well as you could hope. Fortunately, there were enough of them to pull it off. Dredge are furious, but falling quickly. I think you could safely outdistance them at this point. You're almost free of this nightmare. What to do? Get out of here or leave no dredge alive. Run from dredge. Not after everything you've been through. Redouble your efforts. Every last one of them on this field are going to go down. Let's put Hakan in instead for him. They both seem to suck about equally. this ain't a bad one. And they put all my stuff back up on the non-injured people. Okay, Hakan, you seem to be kind of the weak link very often. So, I have a job for you. Got to kill something. Done with it. Oh, looks like we made it out all right. Schlid. Join me a moment. Stay a while and listen. Oh, the Mender guy. Sounds like a Mender name. How is he? The wrong way. The woman, she's dead, unfortunately. have to go back. Evened. Sooner we get to Grafheim, the better.
Dread grips me as we approach Grafheim. None of us expected to see a city unscathed. But what we find steals the very breath from my lungs.
Oh wow. So much for this being the place to head. Lest thy not come home, lest they not come home. Switching back now. That's right, we have this conflict. What did I do? What did I do to piss asshole off? Why are you all angry with me? What did I do? Alright. Switch you out for one of them. Surrounded sucks. Let's see. Remember who's kind of what on this team now. bit of a serious move there. Is so awful. I feel like archers are pretty weak. And her and Ursa in particular feel really, really weak. Well, I guess Ursa's not really a factor though anymore. She's gone, huh? Fucked. Him basically a non-threat, being that low a strength, so. Archers leveled, they wouldn't feel so freaking weak, but because I mean, I guess like the rook guy, he has a couple of levels and he's not near as weak, but he's still not like all that powerful. Armor. For her. Really? Come on. Down. And pillage mode. Can't stay here. If we're not murdered in our sleep, it's only a matter of time before the dredge find their way in. He's just straight crazy, that's why. As soon as those gates were shut, Echo walked into the Great Hall and sliced open the chieftain like a narwhal. Of course he was playing us. Why did I agree to this last week? I must have thought I would get something good from him. By now the dredge have already flooded the south. Wormtoe is the only thing that makes sense. Cross the wastes. Wormtoe, huh? Oh, will you? Yes, you can come with. In exchange for food, you can totally come with. Though the catch is he wants to come with. Fighters desperate to get out of here. Sounds great. Oh, it is so worth the risk. Onif. Yeah, don't cross us or my big varl will break your face in. Right, well, let's just place out these dudes. Plus two will on rest. That's not that great. Extra armor is always good, on the other hand. Take you in, so I can only put it on one of these two. Oh, they're not high enough level, that's why. Got it, right. Do we have any promotions? Yeah, we should have a couple. I think Oddleaf. Oh wow, she can have 13 willpower? Jeez. That would lead me to believe. Start upping exertion. Okay, I guess maybe that's kind of the big thing for archers, is they get to have lots of willpower still, eh. Which, normally I'm a big fan of ranged characters, that's why I'm kind of disappointed with their lackluster performance, it seems. Raid Master. Oh, shit. Okay, I'm actually running into a renown wall for trying to promote. I guess I'll have to start actually paying attention to whether I want to promote somebody or not. Thank you. guess I'm not really gonna be. Hopefully I'll have a chance to buy some shit before I leave. Gotta remember to hang on to the renown after this battle and not use it to level, but use it to go buy stuff. Onef leads you to an inconspicuous building. This is them, he says to the handful of guards inside who lower their weapons. In a concealed basement, you find an enormous store of food and sundries. Grab what you can, he mutters. Make multiple trips to take everything. Take what you can and get out. Take what you can and destroy the rest. No, fuck that. Make multiple trips, take everything. I'll fucking fend off Ekel and his jackass little guardsman if he comes around. Hauling the entire store of supplies out of the basement takes more time than you expected. Each moment you imagine Ekel's men rounding the corner. Yells in the distance mark that fear becoming a reality. You get the others out and emerge from the building in time to beat them in battle. So I'd imagine I could have avoided the fight by choosing one of the other options, but fuck that. I would rather get a shit ton of supplies and kill this dude. And destroy the supplies. Honestly, that's just mean. What about all those other people out there who would starve? What the fuck? This is a fucked up ass. What a weird starting position.
Thank you. Thank you.
Alright. We're going to take just a quick break, and I'll be back in about 5 minutes or so.